Mark 4.
Mareka chapter 4.
From verse 14.
Ritume verse 14.
I just want to show you that why we have pressures.
Kinyoko livoncha why rena le khatelelo.
Mark 4.
Mareka chapter 4.
From verse 14.
Utowa u verse 14.
I don't have a boundary. Tell your
neighbor. Ucha mto leng khaufi akina milwane.
If you read verse 14.
Awala verse 14.
I just want us to read there.
Kenya korere re bale ana mo.
You will learn something from there.
Uto ituta sesengwana mo.
Can you read verse 14? Say what?
The sower
sows the word.
Amen.
And verse 15 says, and these are the ones by the wayside where the word is sown. When they hear, Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. 16. These likewise are the ones who sown on stony grounds, who when they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness, and they have no root in themselves, and so endure only for a time. Afterward, when tribulation or persecution arises for the word's sake, immediately they stumble. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want us to look that verse maybe in Amplified Bible.
Amplified.
You will find why I'm talking about. It talks about the second group. The first group is the one that on the wayside. When the word of God is sown, the birds just come quickly or Satan come and take it away. But these other ones, they receive the word with amen. These are Christians who are going all through pressures. If you can read there, you realize that. Let me just read for you.
Erekelebalenka Amplified Version.
In 15.
Verse 15.
It says, this, in the first group you can see.
Mo first group only one.
16, in the similar way, this in the second group.
Baba group
are the ones on whom the seed was sown on rocky, who, when they hear the word, immediately receive it
with joy.
But accept it only superficially. And they have no roots. If you can see the root in themselves.
Abana
so they endure only for a while. Then when trouble or persecution comes because of the word, immediately they are offended and displeased at being associated with me and stumble and fall away. What are your words when you face pressures? Just write words when you face pressures or under pressures.
Hawe na oleka tasi ya khatelelo.
I want to teach you this. I found that many times we Christians,
kinyo korera seka orke tutsu rhanchir na bapuluswa,
our ways makes us to stumble.
Manchare na dia ore rekhopiwe.
Physically we are there, but what we are speaking, we are already defeated.
Kana Mariana mo mara tshe re di bolelang ka melomo re setse re tlotswe.
You could see Jesus speaking about the second group as Christians who say, I receive all the time.
Eh group ya bobedi ke ya ba pholoswa badulang ba re re amogela methayo yothe.
But the Bible says the persecution will come.
Mara Bible re di taisho di tota.
Challenges will come.
Di challenge le tsona di ite.
When they come because of the word. The word of God attracts persecution.
Lintshe la modimo ke lona le le gokelang wa ubitsa.
But if we have the word in us, when we are pressurized, we will release the word. The Bible shows that we will just tolerate for a while,
endure for a while,
because we don't have roots. In other words, the root is the one that when the word comes, it will add to that root. Therefore, you have
root.
But when the word comes here and stand on the root, so the pressures of persecution, suffering, troubles, when they start to increase
because of the word,
that is where now you release the word and you don't hold on. We need to learn how to sustain or to be sustained when we are facing pressures. Because in Matthew 12 verse 33, if you can read to
37,
Jesus shows that many people are judged by their ways. Because your words shows your spiritual condition. Can you just read, Mama, verse 33?
It
says what?
Either make the tree good and its fruits good, or make the tree bad and its fruits bad. For the tree is recognized and judged by its fruits.
You can hear that verse. It shows that your fruits are the ones that determine yourself. Your words shows your spiritual condition. You can reject Christ by ways. Look what happened to Peter. When Jesus was facing trials, he was there, but he was not with him. Listen, many of us, we are here, but by our ways, we are not there. Can you see, when you see pressure, you can reject Christ, or you are proof to stand with Christ. I have read Hebrews 12 verse 1 to 3. It shows how Jesus faced all this hostility of suffering.
He's
endured from all those sinners such a bitter hostility. And the Bible says he was not even tired. Many of times, if you can look at the life of Jesus, you realize that when the pressure increases, he doesn't want to
talk.
Listen to this. Your Christianity is determined by how far you handle the pressures. If you see, you realize that Jesus, even when he stand before Pilate, when he's asked questions, he will keep quiet. Sometimes he will just speak, showing his stand that he's not intimidated by Pilate. He knew that words can reign his stand and his position or his assignment of what he was there for.
Do you
know Pilate offer an opportunity to Jesus and say, why are you so quiet? You need to answer these people. But Jesus also just kept quiet. And he says, do you know that I've got power to release you? And Jesus said, you don't have power. Unless you are given from
above.
There was pressure, but he was still calm. Many of us, when pressures come, we get out of the way. And we sin, not knowing we are sinning, and we end up defiling ourselves by what we say. That's the reason why when we pray, we don't get results, because under pressure, we don't stand in faith. I don't know if you're hearing me. The reason why you don't speak things and they don't exist, those things, or you don't see them manifesting, is because you fluctuate. Pressures come to test your dominance. You don't speak what you say when you're excited. I don't know if you're hearing me. Just look at this verse, we'll read here. In Matthew 26:57. I just want you to see something that happened. When I was reading 57,
Matthew 26.
I just said, this has happened to me. Sometimes when you see Jesus, you see your copy. Let me read for you. Those who had said, verse 57. Those who have said Jesus, led him away to Caiaphas, the high priest, where the scribes and the elders, Sanhedrin, can you see the people there?
Yeah,
illegally together. But Peter followed him at a distance as far as the courtyard, and then also, let me just jump there. Verse 15 now. Now the chief priest and the whole council of Sanhedrin, or Jewish High Court, tried to get false witnesses to testify against Jesus.
Amen.
So that they might have a reason to put him to death. Okay, they found none. Even though many false witnesses came forward. And look at this another stanza. It says, at last two came forward and testified. This man said, I'm able to tear down the temple of God and rebuild in 3 days. The high priest stood up and said to Jesus, have you no answer to give? What is it that these men are testifying against you? Look at verse 63. The Bible says, but Jesus kept silent. Can you see that? And the high priest said to him, I call on you to swear a binding oath by the living God that you tell us whether you are a Christ or the Son of God. Jesus said to him, you have said it, but more than that, I tell you. Can you see that? Jesus here, he kept quiet. I just remember I found this thing. It was part of my lesson. I found that the more when people try to accuse you, I've tried to do that. When you try to show them it's not true, they pressurize you more. So Jesus knew what they will do. When the first witness came forward, what Jesus did, he kept quiet. Two came forward.
Let's
say he said this.
Still,
he keeps silent. He knew that by his words, he can see or change the plan of God. Can I tell you this? Sometimes we change the plan of God by answering where we are not supposed to answer. When the pressure is increasing, let's keep silent. I've learned that if we keep silent, we fulfill what Jesus did. Jesus could just keep silent. These people came together. They planned together. And say, let's find some people. And brought people with lies. So that he will be accused to death. But still, it will not move
Jesus.
But two came forward and said, we heard him. In other words, these are the people who attend the meeting of Jesus. And also they were not understanding what Jesus was meaning. So they heard, they were specific in the words they were speaking. But still, Jesus kept silent. I've learned that in the position of accusation, when you are pressurized, the best way is to keep silent. Because listen to this. If Jesus was spoken, just to speak one word, it will stop his issue of going to the cross. Because Jesus, his assignment, whether he do big miracles or not, the biggest thing he's supposed to do was to die on the cross. So keeping silent was, I'm ready to go there. I'm ready for the will of God. I can't defend myself. We need Christians who understand that pressures will come. Those pressures are coming because of the aim of God upon their lives. Pressures of limitations, persecution, those pressures are very
good.
When they are there, they are telling you, ride on. You are on the right track. Carry on. You are not a failure yet. How can you be pressurized if you are not going anywhere? How can you be pressurized if you are in one place? The reasons why you are getting pressure is because you are moving forward. If you believe, say amen. Listen to this. It's good to be pressurized now and to rain tomorrow. It's good to be stopped now, but hold. Carry on holding. Speak the right ways. Speak those right ways.
And
say, I can't leave Jesus. Even when I'm facing what I'm facing, I won't leave Jesus. Because in me, I might not be having anything outside me, but inside me, there is something that is about to be visible. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let's read Matthew 14:10. You see people coming to Jesus and say, Jesus, John the Baptist, who baptize you, has been killed by King Herod. Jesus knew what will happen here. He said, if I stay here and these people are coming to me, I will be angry. The Bible says, secretly he went to the desert, so that people will move away, otherwise they will cause riot. Jesus didn't want to cause riot.
Jesus,
John's head was cut off. And the disciples came to Jesus and said, hey, you know what happened to the John? They cut off because of the truth. He was telling the truth. I mean,
Herodias
was taken by this man. John was speaking about it. When Jesus heard that, he didn't say yes or true. He just moved out secretly.
O noti tsamaela le konoto.
And people follow him in the desert.
Ba tshala mara wana ke wele hana teng.
He took people from town.
A tshia batho ba utswa mo tsitoropong.
And take them out.
Aba tshia ba isa ka nte.
So listen to this.
Ka re tshela tshang taba e botsa se.
Jesus and John.
Jesu le Johane.
They were always standing together.
Ne batola ba ema mmogo.
And even Jesus one day spoke about John.
Ene le Jesu tshile le ngwe nkela a bolela ka tsona taba ya tsa tsona.
He says, Where did you get out to see?
I don't know where now. Ujeleko kai uyobona.
There was this man.
No ne muntu.
Who was not wearing clothes like of
yana
palace.
Yana sa paradi kubo chakuntong ya khoshi.
That man was more than a
Muna
prophet.
Munaola na afirisha mo profeta.
You could hear Jesus praising John.
No le Jesu areta Johane.
So now when they come to tell.
Tana aba ita utothalusa.
And say hey.
Para wena we.
His head was cut off. What do you say?
Ape toya gaeba itushicho uringi jano.
Jesus was say. Why they did that? Maybe. Yes, sorry. He was supposed to have said that.
Mutomo wena tshwantse o bucheka tsona tsela yena
yo. No.
Ara uwa.
Let me just go away.
Ere nna ke no itsepelela ke tsamae.
And went to the bush.
Atsamaya ya mole hana teng kona he.
Everybody follow him there.
Mo motho ka ofela nkile a molatela na ko uwe.
And when he was there.
Ha le yana ke uwe.
He start a new thing.
Atoma ndo imtsana mo.
Because most of the time.
Ka bana hanchi hangata.
We love to defend people that we know.
Re rata o tshireletsa batho ba re batsebang.
Whether they are right or wrong.
A right o ba wrong.
We can speak for them.
Re ka no ba bolelela.
And we end up sinning.
Ra felletsa re dia divi.
Jesus knew that the ministry of John
Jesu
was finished.
Jesu na tsebo ministry wa Johane na ufedile.
And he's supposed to go home.
Na tshontsho ya hae.
Whether he can be killed or
Akaba kamulayo re ba moapia.
But he was going to heaven.
Mara ya le hodimo.
So he could not even try to say those who did that were wrong.
Ah bolela le hore ba ba dileng to were siona.
Or were right.
O ba ba dia yona.
Because no one will understand
that. Ha motho na ta kwishisha.
He moved away.
O ila sipila.
So that he must not answer anything.
Ore asikata fetola sino le ka sisi.
If he said they are wrong.
Ah bolela re ba le liposo.
He was saying he was not supposed to go to
heaven. Na bolela re yena a swane lo ya le godimo.
If he said they are right.
Ha bolela re ba dia chona.
He was also guilty like them who killed.
Na to swana le bona ba mmulaileng aba mlato.
So
yena wa ya idiang kutjwa le konotong ba sammo.
This is the time that when you see
ke nako ya ra o wena o bona.
There's a pressure, you run away.
Re gona le gatello wa chaba.
I don't know if you hear me.
Na ke tsebore le ntona.
Sometimes your response.
Na go tshe dingwe wa ra ba hahao.
Put you in a cage.
O tsena ka ra mutsenya ka ra mohoma.
There's some things you don't need
wena
to say.
Wena le dilo tseo sa talking o di bolela.
As a Christian.
O jalo ka mo
pressure. You are pressurized.
A wena ba o hatelela ina.
You need to keep quiet.
O tokono e gomolela.
Why you keep quiet?
Why o gomola he?
Because the day you utter a statement.
Ka le ka le o tantsha
bring a change upon your life.
O tsa phetogo di mabophelo jwa gago.
Is the time when something will happen.
Ke nako yo taba o diala ntongwe.
We don't need Christians.
Are toke ba pholoswane.
We just speak everything.
Ba no bolela ka moka ka ofela dilo.
A Christians who just speak everything.
Mo pholoswane o bolela go gang.
Cannot change anything.
A go no feto sa silo.
We need Christians who can speak faith.
Tsana re toka ba pholoswane ba bolela ng tshatumelo.
Even when they are pressurized.
Le ge ba tswa ba kwa ba gatelela.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
A ke tsebe ga le ntwa.
Keep silent and speak faith.
Wena o bolela tshatumelo fela.
Take you there.
Mo di mota o isa mo
tshwanetse.
Na ke se bolela ntwana.
This is the time that when you are facing a challenge.
Ha wena o kopana le challenge ya
bophelo.
Wena wa gomola.
He who sees.
Yena ye o ya bonang.
In dark can still see that challenge.
Mo le tshwenye o bona challenge je di jwa.
This is the time that when you are facing.
Ye ke nako ya o re o kopana le tshona bophelo.
You are not afraid.
A o chabi silo.
You just keep silent.
Wena no gomola fela.
Don't allow your pressure.
O se ka dumela o hatelwa ha.
Bring something that is hidden.
Oroti sentongwe ephi efitaiche.
There are some characters that are hidden.
Ona le mekgwa engwe ya ofitea.
They will be found by the time of pressures.
Ka tlhokomela nako ya o gatelelwa.
Listen to this.
Telechang
he. If you want to see you a Christian.
Nyoko bona ga lo rupulishwe
ka nne. Let's see you under pressure.
Are u bona ha u ba o hateletse.
If you want to see you a Christian.
Ha nyoko bona re ka nne to pulishwe.
We want to know you under pressure.
Ba nyoko tseba ha u le ka hatelelo.
How are you under pressure?
Botsa le ka wena o fuma ka mogwamang a o le ka tasia khatelela.
Under pressure you can insult.
Ka tasia khatelela o ruwana wa ruwana.
Under pressure you can revive.
Ka tasia khatelela e bile o ka fetola.
You can forget to pray.
E bile o ka ha kuna le bana lo ruwana pela.
You speak, I mean, doubts.
What am
I
bile la ka maka lo swaba?
I don't know if you are hearing that.
I get seba lento.
Pastor say hey.
Go khwata motho leng khaus.
We need to know you under pressure.
Re toka o tseba lo ka ta sia khatelela.
That pressure you are facing.
O khatelela go ka ta maka pa na le wona.
Is searching for the true Christianity.
O nya ka phuluso ya nita mo niti mo go wena.
Let me just read some scriptures.
Ere ke palele ntshwele lengwe.
If you read Mark 4,
Mareka 4.
35 to 40.
Revelate 35 of itahu 40.
You see the disciples with Jesus.
O tabana ba roti o bana le Jesu.
in a boat.
Kara lesila wate.
And there was a pressure.
Ene neona le khatelelo.
When the pressure came.
Awo khatelelego la ofita.
The Bible says Jesus was asleep.
Bible re Jesu na swere buroko.
In other words, Jesus was quiet.
Amang chama we Jesu na khomoje.
Can you just ask somebody say, when you pray and there's no answer?
Awo rapela petrolo ya sate.
How are your response?
Wo araba joang.
You are praying for something is not coming. And the pressure is increasing.
And the pressure
the disciples say to Jesus, when they wake him up, they say, Jesus, you don't care. Because what they wanted was everything must run smooth. They were supposed to have trusted Jesus when he said, let's go on the other side. Meaning that we are going to reach
there.
If Jesus is quiet, they were supposed to keep silent. Many times we speak those words, Jesus, you don't care. By our actions, we end up showing that he doesn't care. Sometimes we speak words of showing that he's not even there. Can I tell you this? When they wake up, they say, Jesus, you don't care that we are dying. Many times we talk about the end because we have got fear of the end. Not knowing that Jesus is taking us somewhere. The pressure that you are facing is there to prove that your God is alive. I don't care what you are facing, but that pressure is there. It's looking for the answer from God. Whether you are getting pressures from work, getting pressures from business or whatever you are doing, getting pressures from your marriage, but those pressures are there looking for the answers from God. This week, God is about to answer someone who's under pressure. Can you just tell you, are you under pressure? Some people, when they are under pressure, they pray too much. They just pray. That to speak the words of faith. Other they cry. There are many things that people can do under pressure. Other they take a pillow on the bed and put it on top of their head. They've got nothing to do. They don't know what to do. I see some Christians under pressure. When you search their Christianity, you don't find it. I thank God for the pressure you are going through. It's looking for the trouble. It's looking for the answers that the Lord is about to give. Don't be dismayed. Don't be frightened. You're about to see something that you have never seen. Carry on speaking the words of faith. Carry on trusting under pressure. Carry on. You will see the results. You are about to see the results. God is about to shame your enemy. He's about to prove his power. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If you are causing impact, you'll be challenged. Trouble will come. Lack will come. Tough times will come. But I want to prophesy. This week, that pressure you were going through is about to leave you. I say it's about to leave you. Can you just read James 3? If we read verse 2, it says, for we all stumble and sin in many ways.
Amen.
And if anyone does not stumble on what he says, into brackets say, never saying the wrong thing, is a perfect man. In other words, when we are pressurized, is to make us imperfect. A perfect man When it's pressurized, it doesn't stumble. It doesn't change on what he said. Can you see when you are facing a challenge? You just conclude, God can hear me. Maybe I need to change what I'm praying for.
And I pray for this one.
Speak one thing until it manifests. You might be looking like you are trying life, but there's a perfection that is coming. I said there's a perfection that is coming. That's why I say, hey, what you're facing is nothing compared to what God is preparing you. If you don't stumble in your ways, speak something. You will see it. Speak until you see it. Speak something. And God will never allow a person like me, a person like you, to fall down, whether they come in another way or in a wrong way or in a way you can't see. The Lord will sustain you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Are you listening to me? Whoever is against you will be surprised you are moving forward. In that pressure you are going through, you won't fall down. You will carry on. The pressure is like a fertilizer. It's like a fertilizer. It's fertilizing you. Sometimes you feel pain. So that you must not run. Carry on running. It will get out by itself. Sometimes you face lack of problems. No one understand you. But the Lord who calls you, the Lord who knows you, will never allow you to die. You will reach your destiny. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Ask your neighbor, what kind of pressure are you going through? The pressure you are going through, you are going through because you are going to master it. If you are going through rejection, it's because you are about to be celebrated. If you are going through lack, it's because abundance is coming. If you have got financial crisis, you are about to be a millionaire. Any pressure, you are pressurized so that you must not speak the right thing and see the right thing that is coming. I don't care what you are facing, but I'm speaking against that pressure. Leave the people of God. Leave the people of God. In the name of Jesus. That's why people who are Christians,
that is why Baba Lengwa Pulusa,
when they were told in the book of James, if you are suffering, pray. That scripture is talking about if you are suffering, call the scripture of showing that you are rich. Let the weak man say, I'm strong. If we reach, let's carry on. Maybe we can reach Proverbs 6 verse 24. I'll tell you something that I written in the Bible.
But
the writer of Proverbs wrote this. Teach me and I will be silent. Show me how I have
erred.
Can you see that verse there? Just read Job 7 also.
Verse 11.
Just read that verse loud.
Job chapter 7.
Verse 11.
Therefore, Job
made a mistake. Just read.
Job dirile phoso mo are. Therefore, I will not restrain my mouth. I will speak in the anguish of my spirit. I will complain in the bitterness of my soul, O Lord.
You can hear that verse there. Job went forward to say you will complain loud. The Bible says Job never sinned.
Bible re Job a sanga a sinye.
When Job faced pressure, he sinned.
Ha kopana lo hane le ntatalelo a ta sinya.
This verse shows Job sinned.
Verse e bontsho re Job o ila sinye.
He said, I will refrain, I will complain.
Ke to bilela.
I'll speak in the anguish of my spirit.
Ke ta bolela botlhoko mo moyeng wa ka.
Can you just read? I want to show you where Job repented.
Ke nyoko le bontsha Job a re yo sokolowa.
When his wife was coming, he reprimanded.
But when the
pressure was increasing, he told God, I will complain louder.
Have
you ever found that you are telling God now loudly? As if he doesn't care. Can you see, read Job 27, verse 4. That's where Job repented. Because here in the beginning he was complaining and he told the Lord, I will carry on making noise. Just read that verse 24.
My lips will not speak unjustly, nor will my tongue utter deceit.
Job here repents. He said, my lips will not speak unjustly, or I utter deceit. In the beginning, when he's facing pressure, he said, Lord, I will complain loud now. If you are God, show up. He was complaining. Sometimes even to say, if I'm a servant of God,
it's
a complaint. If you're a servant of God, but if I'm a servant of God, you are complaining already. If you are a Christian and you understand that you are a servant of God, you understand that when you say the name of Jesus, something will happen. Sometimes you say, if I'm a servant of God, as I know I am, you're complaining. And whom are you answering? You can just see you're complaining. You want God to do something by force to prove that you are his servant. If you read that verse, just read that verse again, verse
4.
He said what? My lips will not speak unjustly. Nor will my tongue utter deceit. I mean, you will understand. That's what Job was speaking. You know
Job 42.
Already was speaking what is right. That's where now he began to pray for people. He prayed for his friends. And God brought everything. Look at David in Psalm 39 verse 1. Just read verse 1, Mama.
Psalm 31 is, I said, I will guard my ways that I may not sin with my tongue. I will muzzle my mouth while the wicked are in my presence.
My God. Here he said, David said, I will guard my ways so that I will not sin by my tongue. But when sinners are there, I'll keep silent. This man was saying, I don't want to speak with the wicked.
Because
I'll speak unjustly. I can end up jesting. I can end up making unnecessary jokes.
Whereas
my way is under pressure is to change the pressure. If you are facing any pressure from today, you can speak ways of faith to change that pressure. Even Jesus said, if your faith is like a seed, like
you
can speak with this mountain. Jesus was talking about pressure. and say, go away from me. You're thrown away where nobody cannot find you. Can you ask your neighbor, what kind of pressure are you going through? Look at your neighbor, you will see pressures. You will see pressures. Pressures everywhere. Today, those pressures will leave you. I said, those pressures will leave you. Can you just ask you that? What are you facing? Do you remember the 10 spies that were sent by Moses? When they saw pressure, what did they say, no, 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 we cannot go there now. We cannot go there. But Joshua and Caleb said, no, no, God has spoken. Because any pressure is searching for the word of God in you. Whether there's Goliath, whether there's Amalekites or
Midian,
those pressures, they need the word of God. I don't know if you're hearing me. I speak against the pressure of leg. That pressure you are overcoming today. I see you succeeding today. I see you moving forward today. I see breakthrough today. That's what are you facing? It's a pressure. And that pressure need you to speak what is right, the word of God, until you see the reason. I prophesy you today, the words you will speak, you will see the result of it. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Are you ready to defy pressures? Are you ready to defy delay? Are you ready to move forward? I don't care the pressure you're going through. It will never separate you with the word of God. That pressure that you're going through, that pressure that you are facing is a fertilizer. Where you are going, I see you moving forward. Say, I will move forward. Devil, you have got no other strategy except using pressures. He look at your weak points and he pressurized them. It's as good as when you are injured and the blood is coming out. When you see that spot, he pressurizes it. But if you are perfect, you are speaking. And there's not any spot. He surrenders and leaves you. And what you say will come to pass. How many of you are ready to speak something today? Rise up, rise up, rise up.